Chrono Trigger. Square re-released a ported version by TOS in Japan for the PlayStation in 1999, later repackaged with a Final Fantasy IV port as Final Fantasy Chronicles in 2001 for the North American market. A slightly enhanced Chrono Trigger, again ported by TOS, was released for the Nintendo DS in North America and Japan in 2008, and PAL regions in 2009. Chrono Trigger was a critical and commercial success upon release, and is frequently cited as one of the best video games of all time. Nintendo Power magazine described aspects of Chrono Trigger as revolutionary, including its multiple endings, plot-related side quests focusing on character development, unique battle system, and detailed graphics. Chrono Trigger was the third best-selling game of 1995 in Japan, shipping 2.65 million copies worldwide by March 2003. The Nintendo DS version sold 790,000 copies by March 2009. Chrono Trigger was also ported to iMode mobile phones, Virtual Console, the PlayStation Network, iOS devices, Android devices, and Microsoft Windows. Chrono Trigger features standard role-playing video game gameplay. The player controls the protagonist and his companions in the game's two-dimensional fictional world, consisting of various forests, cities, and dungeons. Navigation occurs via an overworld map, depicting the landscape from a scaled-down overhead view. Areas such as forests, cities, and similar places are depicted as more realistic scaled-down maps, in which players can converse with locals to procure items and services, solve puzzles and challenges, or encounter enemies. Chrono Trigger's gameplay deviates from that of traditional Japanese RPGs in that, rather than appearing in random encounters, many enemies are openly visible on field maps or lie in wait to ambush the party. Contact with enemies on a field map initiates a battle that occurs directly on the map rather than on a separate battle screen. Players and enemies may use physical or magical attacks to wound targets during battle, and players may use items to heal or protect themselves. Each character and enemy has a certain number of hit points. Successful attacks reduce that character's hit points, which can be restored with potions and spells. When a playable character loses all hit points, they faint. If all the player's characters fall in battle, the game ends and must be restored from a previously saved chapter, except in specific storyline-related battles that allow or force the player to lose. Between battles, the player can equip his/her characters with weapons, armor, helmets, and accessories that provide special effects, such as increased attack power or defense against magic, and various consumable items can be used both in and out of battles. Items and equipment can be purchased in shops or found on field maps, often in treasure chests. By exploring new areas and fighting enemies, players progress through Chrono Trigger's story. Chrono Trigger uses an active time battle system, a staple of Square's Final Fantasy game series designed by Hiroyuki Ito for Final Fantasy IV, named Active Time Battle 2.0. Each character can take action in battle once a personal timer dependent on the character's speed statistic counts to zero. Magic and special physical techniques are handled through a system called Tex. Tex deplete a character's magic points, a numerical meter similar to hit points, and often have special areas of effect. Some spells damage huddled monsters, while others can harm enemies spread in a line. Enemies often change positions during battle, creating opportunities for tactical tech use. A unique feature of Chrono Trigger NoWiki_NoWiki_S-Tech system is that numerous cooperative techniques exist. Each character receives 8 personal techs which can be used in conjunction with others to create double and triple techs for greater effect. For instance, Chrono's sword spinning cyclone tech can be combined with Luca's flame toss to create flame whirl. When characters with compatible techs have enough magic points available to perform their techniques, the game automatically displays the combo as an option. Chrono Trigger features several other distinct gameplay traits, including time travel. Players have access to 7 eras of the game world's history, and past actions affect future events. Throughout history, players find new allies, complete side quests, and search for keynote villains. Time travel is accomplished via portals and pillars of light called time gates, as well as a time machine named Epic. The game contains 13 unique endings. The ending the player receives depends on when and how they reach and complete the game's final battle. Chrono Trigger DS features a new ending that can be accessed from the end of time upon completion of the final extra dungeon and optional final boss. Chrono Trigger also introduces a new game plus option. After completing the game, the player may begin a new game with the same character levels, techniques, and equipment, excluding money, with which they ended the previous playthrough. However, certain items central to the storyline are removed and must be found again, such as the sword Masamune. Square has since employed the new Game Plus concept in later titles, including Chrono Cross, Parasite Eve, Vagrant Story, Final Fantasy X-2, and Chrono Trigger takes place in a world similar to Earth, with eras such as the prehistoric age, in which primitive humans and dinosaurs share the Earth, the Middle Ages, replete with knights, monsters, and magic, and the post-apocalyptic future, where destitute humans and sentient robots struggle to survive. The characters frequently travel through time to obtain allies, gather equipment, and learn information to help them in their quest. The party also gains access to the end of time, represented as Year, which serves as a hub to travel back to other time periods. The party eventually acquires a time machine vehicle known as the Wings of Time, nicknamed the Epic. The vehicle is capable of time travel between any time period without first having to travel to the end of time. Chrono Trigger No Wiki less than slash No Wiki greater than S6 playable characters, plus one optional character, come from different eras of history. Chrono Trigger begins in AD 1000 with Chrono, Marl, and Luca. Chrono is the silent protagonist, characterized as a fearless young man who wields a cane in battle. Marl, Princess Nadia, lives in Guardia Castle, though sheltered. At heart she's a princess who enjoys hiding her royal identity. Luca is a friend of Chrono's and a mechanical genius. Her home is filled with laboratory equipment and machinery. From the era of AD 2300 comes Robo, or Prometheus, designation R66Y, a robot with near-human personality created to assist humans. Lying dormant in the future, Robo is found and repaired by Luca, and joins the group out of gratitude. The fiercely confident Isla dwells in 65 million BC. Unmatched in raw strength, Isla is the chief of the Oka village and leads her people in war against a species of humanoid reptiles known as Reptites. The last two playable characters are Frog and Magus. Frog originated in AD 600. He is a former squire once named Glenn, who was turned into an anthropomorphic frog by Magus, who also killed his friend Cyrus. Chivalrous but mired in regret, Frog dedicates his life to protecting Lene, the Queen of Guardia, and avenging Cyrus. Meanwhile, Guardia in AD 600 is in a state of conflict against the Mystics, known as Fiends in the US/DS port, a race of demons and intelligent animals who wage war against humanity under the leadership of Magus, a powerful sorcerer. Magus's seclusion conceals a long-lost past. He was formerly known as Janus, the young prince of the Kingdom of Zeal, which was destroyed by Lavos in 12,000 BC. The incident sent him forward through time, and as he ages, he plots revenge against Lavos and broods over the fate of his sister, Shala. Lavos, the game's main antagonist who awakens and ravages the world in AD 1999, is an extraterrestrial, parasitic creature that harvests DNA and the Earth's energy for its own growth. In AD 1000, Chrono and Marl watch Luca and her father demonstrate her new teleporter at the Millennial Fair. When Marl volunteers to be teleported, her pendant interferes with the device and creates a time portal into which she is drawn. After Chrono and Luca separately recreate the portal and find Theme Selves in AD 600, they find Marl only to see her vanish before their eyes. Luca realizes that this time period's kingdom has mistaken Marl for an ancestor of her who had been kidnapped, thus putting off the recovery effort for her ancestor and creating a grandfather paradox. Chrono and Luca, with the help of Frog, restore history to normal by recovering the kidnapped queen. After the three part ways with Frog and return to the present, Chrono is arrested on charges of kidnapping the princess and sentenced to death by the current Chancellor of Guardia. Luca and Marl help Chrono to flee, haphazardly using another time portal to escape their pursuers. This portal lands them in AD 2300, where they learn that an advanced civilization has been wiped out by a giant creature known as Lavos that appeared in 1999. The three vow to find a way to prevent the future destruction of their world. After meeting and repairing Robo, Chrono and his friends find Gaspar, an old sage at the end of time, who helps them acquire magical powers and travel through time by way of several pillars of light. Research in AD 1000 tells them about Magus summoning Lavos into the world. To repair Frog's sword, the Masamune, they travel to prehistoric times and meet Isla. After returning to AD 600, they challenge Magus, believing him to be the source of Lavos. After the battle, a summoning spell causes a time gate that throws Chrono and his friends to the past. Back in prehistory, Isla joins the group to battle the Reptites and witness the origin of Lavos. They learn that Lavos was an alien being that arrived on the planet millions of years in the past, and began to absorb DNA and energy from every living creature before rising and raising the planet's surface in 1999 so that it could spawn a new generation. Entering a gate created by the newly landed Lavos, they go to BC 12,000, and Ice Age, where the party finds the Kingdom of Zeal, who recently discovered Lavos and seeks to drain its power to achieve immortality through the Mammon Machine. Zeal's leader, Queen Zeal, imprisons Chrono and friends on orders of the Prophet, a mysterious figure who has recently begun advising the Queen. Though Zeal's daughter Shala frees them, the Prophet forces her to banish them from the realm and seal the time gate they used to travel to the Dark Ages. They return next to AD 2300 to find a time machine called the Wings of Time, or Epic, which can access any time period without using a time gate. They travel back to BC 12,000 to stop Zeal from activating the Mammon Machine in the Ocean Palace. Lavos awakens, disturbed by the Mammon Machine. The Prophet reveals himself to be Magus and unsuccessfully tries to kill the creature. The party is beaten, and a broken Chrono stands up to Lavos before being vaporized by a powerful blast. Shala transports the rest of the party back to the surface before Lavos destroys the Ocean Palace and the Kingdom of Zeal. Chrono's friends awaken in a village and find Magus, who confesses that he used to be Prince Janus of Zeal. In his memories, it is revealed that the disaster at Ocean Palace scattered the gurus of Zeal across time and sent him to the Middle Ages. Janus took the alias of Magus and gained a cult of followers while plotting to summon and kill Lavos in revenge for the death of his sister, Shala. When Lavos appeared after his battle with Chrono and his allies, he was cast back to the time of Zeal and presented himself to them as a prophet. At this point, Magus is either killed by the party, killed in a duel with Frog, or spared and convinced to join the party. As Chrono's friends depart, the ruined Ocean Palace rises into the air as the Black Omen. The group turns to Gaspar for help, and he gives them a Chrono trigger, an egg-shaped device that allows the group to replace Chrono just before the moment of death with a doppelganger. Chrono and his friends then gather power by helping people across time with Gaspar's instructions. Stop their journeys involve defeating the remnants of the mystics, stopping Robo's maniacal AI creator, addressing Frog's feelings towards Cyrus, locating and charging up the mythical Sunstone, retrieving the rainbow shell, and helping restore a forest destroyed by a desert monster. The group enters the Black Omen and defeats Queen Zeal, then successfully battles Lavos, saving the future of their world. If Magus joined the party, he departs to search for Shala. Chrono's mother accidentally enters the time gate at the fair before it closes, prompting Chrono, Marl, and Luca to set out in the Epic to find her while fireworks light up the night sky. Alternatively, if the party use the Epic to break Lavos's outer shell, Marl will help her father hang Naja's bell at the festival and accidentally get carried away by several balloons. Chrono jumps on to help her, but cannot bring them down to Earth. Hanging on in each other's arms, the pair travel through the cloudy, moonlit sky. Chrono Trigger DS added two new scenarios to the game. In the first, Chrono and his friends can help a lost sanctum of reptites, who reward powerful items and armor. The second scenario adds ties to trigger NoWiki_NoWiki_SQL, Chrono Cross. In a new game plus, the group can explore several temporal distortions to combat shadow versions of Chrono, Marl, and Luca, and to fight Dalton, who promises in defeat to raise an army in the town of Port to destroy the Kingdom of Guardia. The group can then fight the Dream Devourer, a prototypical form of the Time Devourer ray fusion of Shala and Lavos seen in Chrono Cross. A version of Magus pleads with Shala to resist, though she recognizes him as her brother, she refuses to be helped and sends him away. Shala subsequently erases his memories and Magus awakens in a forest, determined to find what he had lost. Chrono Trigger was conceived in 1992 by Hironobu Sakaguchi, producer and creator of the Final Fantasy series, Yuji Horii, director and creator of the Dragon Quest series, and Akira Toriyama, character designer of Dragon Quest and creator of the Dragon Ball comics series. Traveling to the United States to research computer graphics, the three decided to create something that no one had done before. After spending over a year considering the difficulties of developing a new game, they received a call from Kazuhiko Aoki, who offered to produce. The four met and spent 4 days brainstorming ideas for the game. Square convened 50 to 60 developers, including scenario writer Masato Kato, whom Square designated story planner. Development started in early 1993. An uncredited Square employee suggested that the team develop a time travel themed game, which Kato initially opposed, fearing repetitive, dull gameplay. Kato and Harai then met several hours per day during the first year of development to write the game's plot. Square intended to license the work under the Seiken Densetsu franchise and gave it the working title of Maru Island. Hiramichi Tanaka, the future director of Chrono Cross, monitored Toriyama's early designs. The team hoped to release it on Nintendo's planned Super Famicom disk drive. When Nintendo cancelled the project, Square reoriented the game for release on a Super Famicom cartridge and rebranded it as Chrono Trigger. Tanaka credited the ROM cartridge platform for enabling seamless transition to battles on the field map. Aoki ultimately produced Chrono Trigger, while director credits were attributed to Akihiko Matsui, Yoshinori Kaitis, and Takashi Tokita. Toriyama designed the game's aesthetic, including characters, monsters, vehicles, and the look of each era. Masato Kato also contributed character ideas and designs. Kato planned to feature Gaspar as a playable character and Toriyama sketched him, but he was cut early in development. The development staff studied the drawings of Toriyama to approximate his style. Sakaguchi and Harai supervised. Sakaguchi was responsible for the game's overall system and contributed several monster ideas. Other notable designers include Tetsuya Takahashi, the graphic director, and Yasuyuki Hone, Tetsuya Nomura, and Yusuke Nora, who worked as field graphic artists. Yasuhiko Kamada programmed graphics, and cited Ridley Scott's visual work in Devilmalion as an inspiration for the game's lighting. Kamada made the game's luminosity and color choice lay between that of Secret of Mana and the Final Fantasy series. Features originally intended to be used in Secret of Mana or Final Fantasy IV, also under development at the same time, were appropriated by the Chrono Trigger team. Yuji Harai, a fan of time travel fiction, such as the TV series The Time Tunnel, fostered a theme of time travel in his general story outline of Chrono Trigger with input from Akira Toriyama. Harai liked the scenario of the grandfather paradox surrounding Marl. Concerning story planning, Harai commented, "If there's a fair ground, I just write that there's a fair ground, I don't write down any of the details." Then the staff brainstorm and come up with a variety of attractions to put in. Sakaguchi contributed some minor elements, including the character Gato. He liked Marl's drama and reconciliation with her father. Masato Kato subsequently edited and completed the outline by writing the majority of the game's story, including all the events of the 12,000 BC era. He took pains to avoid what he described as a long string of errands, such as, do this, take this, defeat these monsters, or plant this flag. Kato and other developers held a series of meetings to ensure continuity, usually attended by around 30 personnel. Kato and Harai initially proposed Chrono's death, though they intended he stay dead, the party would have retrieved an earlier, living version of him to complete his quest. Square deemed the scenario too depressing and asked that Chrono be brought back to life later in the story. Kato also devised the system of multiple endings because he could not branch the story out to different paths. Yoshinori Kaitis and Takashi Tokita then wrote various subplots. They also devised an active time event logic system, where you can move your character around during scenes, even when an NPC is talking to you, and with players talking to different people and steering the conversation in different directions, allowing each scene to have many permutations. Kato became friends with composer Yasunori Mitsuda during development, and they would collaborate on several future projects. Katsuhisa Higuchi programmed the battle system, which hosted combat on the map without transition to a special battleground as most previous Square games had done. Higuchi noted extreme difficulty in loading battles properly without slowdowns or a brief, black loading screen. The game's use of animated monster sprites consumed much more memory than previous Final Fantasy games, which used static enemy graphics. Hironobu Sakaguchi likened the development of Chrono Trigger to playing around with Toriyama's universe, citing the inclusion of humorous sequences in the game that would have been impossible with something like Final Fantasy. When Square Company suggested a non-human player character, developers created Frog by adapting one of Toriyama's sketches. The team created the end of time to help players with hints, worrying that they might become stuck and need to consult a walkthrough. The game's testers had previously complained that Chrono Trigger was too difficult. As Harai explained, it's because we know too much. The developers think the game's just right, that they're being too soft. They're thinking from their own experience. The puzzles were the same. Lots of players didn't figure out things we thought they'd get easily. Sakaguchi later cited the unusual desire of beta testers to play the game a second time or travel through time again as an affirmation of the new game plus feature, Wherever we could, we tried to make it so that a slight change in your behavior caused subtle differences in people's reactions, even down to the smallest details. I think the second playthrough will hold a whole new interest. The game's reuse of locations due to time traveling made bug fixing difficult, as corrections would cause unintended consequences in other eras. Chrono Trigger was scored primarily by Yasunori Mitsuda, with contributions from veteran Final Fantasy composer Nobuo Uematsu, and one track composed by Noriko Matsuda. A sound programmer at the time, Mitsuda was unhappy with his pay and threatened to leave Square if he could not compose music. Hironobu Sakaguchi suggested he score Chrono Trigger, remarking, "Maybe your salary will go up." Mitsuda composed new music and drew on a personal collection of pieces composed over the previous 2 years. He reflected, "I wanted to create music that wouldn't fit into any established genre, music of an imaginary world." The game's director, Masato Kato, was my close friend, and so I'd always talk with him about the setting and the scene before going into writing. Mitsuda slept in his studio several nights, and attributed certain pieces, such as the game's ending theme, to faraway times to inspiring dreams. He later attributed this song to an idea he was developing before Chrono Trigger, reflecting that the tune was made in dedication to a certain person with whom he wanted to share a generation. He also tried to use leitmotifs of the Chrono Trigger main theme to create a sense of consistency in the soundtrack. Mitsuda wrote each tune to be around 2 minutes long before repeating, unusual for Square's games at the time. Mitsuda suffered a hard drive crash that lost around 40 in-progress tracks. After Mitsuda contracted stomach ulcers, Uematsu joined the project to compose 10 pieces and finish the score. Mitsuda turned to watch the ending with the staff before the game's release, crying upon seeing the finished scene. At the time of the game's release, the number of tracks and sound effects was unprecedented. The soundtrack spanned 3 discs in its 1995 commercial pressing. Square also released a 1-disc acid jazz arrangement called The Brink of Time by Guido that year. The Brink of Time came about because Mitsuda wanted to do something that no one else was doing, and he noted that acid jazz and its related genres were uncommon in the Japanese market. Mitsuda considers Chrono Trigger a landmark title which helped mature his talent. While Mitsuda later held that the title piece was rough around the edges, he maintains that it had significant influence on his life as a composer. In 1999, Square produced another 1-disc soundtrack to complement the PlayStation release of Trigger, featuring orchestral tracks used in cutscenes. Tsuyoshi Sekito composed 4 new pieces for the game's bonus features which weren't included on the soundtrack. Some fans were displeased by Mitsuda's absence in creating the port, whose instruments sometimes orally differed from the original games. Mitsuda arranged versions of music from the Chrono series for play. Video game music concerts, presenting the main theme, Frog's theme, and To Faraway Times. He worked with Square Enix to ensure that the music for the Nintendo DS would sound closer to the Super NES version. Mitsuda encouraged feedback about the game's soundtrack from contemporary children, who he thought would expect full symphonic scores blaring out of the speakers. Fans who pre-ordered Chrono Trigger DS received a special music disc containing 2 orchestral arrangements of Chrono Trigger music directed by Natsumi Kameyaka. Square Enix also held a random prize drawing for 2 signed copies of Chrono Trigger sheet music. Mitsuda expressed difficulty in selecting the tune for the orchestral medley, eventually picking a tune from each era and certain character themes. Mitsuda later wrote, "Music from the game was performed live by the Tokyo Symphony Orchestra in 1996 at the Orchestral Game Concert in Tokyo, Japan. A suite of music including Chrono Trigger is a part of the Symphonic World Tour with Video Game Music Play. A video game symphony, where Mitsuda was in attendance for the concert's world premiere in Chicago on May 27, 2006. His suite of Chrono music, comprising Reminiscence, Chrono Trigger, Chrono Cross Times Scar, Frog's Theme, and To Faraway Times was performed. Mitsuda has also appeared with the Eminence Symphony Orchestra as a special guest. Video Games Live has also featured medleys from Chrono Trigger and Chrono Cross. A medley of music from Chrono Trigger made of 1 of the 4 suites of the Symphonic Fantasies concerts in September 2009 which was produced by the creators of the Symphonic Game Music Concert series, conducted by Arnie Roth. Square Enix re-released the game's soundtrack, along with a video interview with Mitsuda in July 2009. The team planned to release Chrono Trigger in late 1994, but release was pushed back to the following year. Early alpha versions of Chrono Trigger were demonstrated at the 1994 and 1995 V-Jump festivals in Japan. A few months prior to the game's release, Square shipped a beta version to magazine reviewers and game stores for review. An unfinished build of the game dated November 17, 1994, it contains unused music tracks, locations, and other features changed or removed from the final release, such as a dungeon named Singing Mountain and its eponymous tune. Some names also differed. The character Soyzaw Slash in the US version was known as Wiener, while Mayonnaise Flea in the US version was named Ketchappa. The ROM image for this early version was eventually uploaded to the internet, prompting fans to explore and document the game's differences, including two unused world map NPC character sprites and presumed additional sprites for certain non-player characters. Around the game's release, Yuji Hirai commented that Chrono Trigger went beyond the development team's expectations, and Hironobu Sakaguchi congratulated the game's graphic artists and field designers. Sakaguchi intended to perfect the sense of dancing I get from exploring Toriyama's worlds in the event that they would make a sequel. Chrono Trigger used a 32-megabit ROM cartridge with battery-backed RAM for saved games, lacking special on-cartridge coprocessors. The Japanese release of Chrono Trigger included art for the game's ending and running counts of items in the player's status menu. Developers created the North American version before adding these features to the original build, inadvertently leaving in vestiges of Chrono Trigger no wiki less than slash no wiki's early development, such as the piece Singing Mountain. Hironobu Sakaguchi asked translator Ted Woolsey to localize Chrono Trigger for English audiences and gave him roughly 30 days to work. Lacking the help of a modern translation team, he memorized scenarios and looked at drafts of commercial player's guides to put dialogue in context. Woolsey later reflected that he would have preferred 2.5 months, and blames his rush schedule on the prevailing attitude in Japan that games were children's toys rather than serious works. Some of his work was cut due to space constraints, though he still considered Trigger one of the most satisfying games he ever worked on or played. Nintendo of America censored certain dialogue, including references to breastfeeding, consumption of alcohol, and religion. The original SNES edition of Chrono Trigger was released on the Wii Download Service Virtual Console in Japan on April 26, 2011, in the US on May 16, 2011, and in Europe on May 20, 2011. Previously in April 2008, a Nintendo Power Reader poll had identified Chrono Trigger as the third most wanted game for the Virtual Console. It went on to receive a perfect score of 10 out of 10 on IGN. Square released an enhanced port of Chrono Trigger developed by TOS in Japan for the Sony PlayStation in 1999. Square timed its release before that of Chrono Cross, the 1999 sequel to Chrono Trigger, to familiarize new players with story leading up to it. This version included anime cutscenes created by original character designer Akira Toriyama's Bird Studio and animated by Toei Animation, as well as several bonus features, accessible after achieving various endings in the game. Scenarist Masato Kato attended planning meetings at Bird Studio to discuss how the ending cutscenes would illustrate subtle ties to Chrono Cross. The port was later released in North America in 2001. Along with a newly translated version of Final Fantasy IV, under the package title Final Fantasy Chronicles. Reviewers criticized Chronicles for its lengthy load times and an absence of new in-game features. This same iteration was also re-released as a downloadable game on the PlayStation Network on October 4, 2011, for the PlayStation 3, PlayStation Vita, and PlayStation Portable. On July 2, 2008, Square Enix announced that they were planning to bring Chrono Trigger to the Nintendo DS handheld platform. Composer Yasunori Mitsuda was pleased with the project, exclaiming finally. After receiving the news from Square Enix and maintaining, it's still a very deep, very high quality game even when you play it today. I'm very interested in seeing what kids today think about it when they play it. Square retained Masato Kato to oversee the port, and TOS to program it. Kato explained, I wanted it to be based on the original Super NES release rather than the PlayStation version. I thought we should look at the additional elements from the PlayStation version, re-examine and rework them to make it a complete edition. That's how it struck me and I told the staff so later on. Square Enix touted the game by displaying Akira Toriyama's original art at the 2008 Tokyo Game Show. The DS re-release contains all of the bonus material from the PlayStation port, as well as other enhancements. The added features include a more accurate and revised translation by Tom Slattery, a dual screen mode which clears the top screen of all menus, a self-completing map screen, and a default run option. It also featured the option to choose between two control schemes, one mirroring the original SNES controls, and the other making use of the DS's touchscreen. Masato Kato participated in development, overseeing the addition of the Monster Battling Arena, two new areas, the Lost Sanctum and the Dimensional Vortex, and a new ending that further foreshadows the events of Chrono Cross. One of the areas within the Vortex uses the Singing Mountain song that was featured in the original Chrono Trigger soundtrack. These new dungeons met with mixed reviews. GameSpot called them frustrating and repetitive, while IGN noted that the extra quests in the game connect extremely well. It was a nominee for Best RPG for the Nintendo DS in IGN's 2008 Video Game Awards. The Nintendo DS version of Chrono Trigger was the 22nd best-selling game of 2008 in Japan. A cell phone version was released in Japan on iMode distribution service on August 25, 2011. An iOS version was released on December 8, 2011. This version is based on the Nintendo DS version, with graphics optimized for iOS. The game was later released for Android on October 29, 2012. An update incorporating most of the features of the Windows version, including the reintroduction of the animated cutscenes, which had been absent from the initial mobile release, was released on February 27, 2018. Square Enix released Chrono Trigger without an announcement for Microsoft Windows via Steam on February 27, 2018. This version includes all content from the Nintendo DS port, the improved graphics from the mobile device releases, support for mouse and keyboard controls, and autosave features, along with additional content such as wallpapers and music. The PC port received negative reception due to its inferior graphical quality, additional glitches, UI adapted for touchscreens, and failure to properly adapt the control scheme for keyboards and controllers. In response, Square Enix provided various UI updates and other improvements over the next few months to address the complaints. The game was a bestseller in Japan. The game's SNES and PS1 iterations have shipped more than 2.36 million copies in Japan and 290,000 abroad. The first 2 million copies sold in Japan were delivered in only 2 months, and the game ended 1995 as the third best-selling game of the year behind And. The game was met with substantial success upon release in North America, and its re-release on the PlayStation as part of the Final Fantasy Chronicles package topped the NPD TRSTS PlayStation sales charts for over 6 weeks. This version was later re-released again in 2003 as part of Sony's Greatest Hits line. Chrono Trigger DS has sold 490,000 copies in Japan, 240,000 in North America and 60,000 in Europe as of March 2009. Chrono Trigger garnered much critical praise in addition to its brisk sales. Famicom Tsushin gave Chrono Trigger first an 8 out of 10 and later a 9 out of 10 in their Reader Cross review. Nintendo Power compared it favorably with Secret of Mana, Final Fantasy, and, citing improved graphics, sound, story and gameplay over past RPG titles. GamePro praised the varied gameplay, the humor, the ability to replay the game with previously built-up characters, and the graphics, which they said far exceed even those of Final Fantasy VI. They commented that combat is easier and more simplistic than in most RPGs, but argued that most players would choose an easier RPG of this caliber over 100 more complicated, but less developed, fantasy role-playing adventures. They gave the game a perfect 5 out of 5 in all four categories: graphics, sound, control, and fun factor. Electronic Gaming Monthly gave it their Game of the Month award, with their four reviewers praising the graphics, story, and music. Chrono Trigger won multiple awards from Electronic Gaming Monthly's 1995 Video Game Awards, including Best Role-Playing Game, Best Music in a Cartridge-Based Game, and Best Super NES Game. Official US PlayStation Magazine described Trigger as original and extremely captivating, singling out its graphics, sound and story as particularly impressive. IGN commented that it may be filled with every imaginable console RPG cliché, but Chrono Trigger manages to stand out among the pack with a captivating story that doesn't take itself too serious and one of the best video game soundtracks ever produced. Other reviewers, such as the staff of RPGFan and RP Gamer, have criticized the game's short length and relative ease compared to its peers. Victoria Earl of Gamasutra praised the game design for balancing developer control with player freedom using design mechanics and a modular approach to narrative. Overall, critics lauded Chrono Trigger for its fantastic yet not overly complex story, simple but innovative gameplay, and high replay value afforded by multiple endings. Online score aggregator Game Rankings lists the original Super NES version as the second highest scoring RPG and 24th highest scoring game ever reviewed. In 2009, Guinness World Records listed it as the 32nd most influential video game in history. Nintendo Power listed the ending to Chrono Trigger as one of the greatest endings in Nintendo history, due to over a dozen endings that players can experience. Tom Hall drew inspiration from Chrono Trigger and other console games in creating Anachronox, and used the campfire scene to illustrate the dramatic depth of Japanese RPGs. Next Generation reviewed the Super NES version of the game, rating it 4 stars out of 5, and stated that it easily qualifies as one of the best RPGs ever made. Chrono Trigger is frequently listed among the greatest video games of all time. It has placed highly on all 6 of multimedia website IGN's top 100 games of all time lists, 4th in 2002, 6th in early 2005, 13th in late 2005, 2nd in 2006, 18th in 2007, and 2nd in 2008. Game Informer called it its 15th favorite game in 2001. Its staff thought that it was the best non-Final Fantasy title Square had produced at the time. GameSpot included Chrono Trigger in the Greatest Games of All Time list released in April 2006, and it also appeared as 28th on an all-time top 100 list in a poll conducted by Japanese magazine Famitsu the same year. In 2004, Chrono Trigger finished runner-up to Final Fantasy VII in the inaugural GameFAQs Video Game Battle. In 2008, readers of Dengeki Online voted it the 8th best game ever made. Nintendo Power No Wiki Less Than / No Wiki Greater Than S 20th Anniversary Issue named it the 5th best Super NES game. In 2012, it came 32nd place on Games Radar's 100 Best Games of All Time list, and first place on its Best JRPGs list. Games Radar named Chrono Trigger the 2nd best Super NES game of all time, behind Super Metroid. In contrast to the critical acclaim of Chrono Trigger's original SNES release, the 2018 Microsoft Windows port of Chrono Trigger was critically panned. Grievances noted by reviewers included tiling errors on textures, the addition of aesthetically intrusive sprite filters, an unattractive GUI carried over from the 2011 mobile release, a lack of graphic customization options, and the inability to remap controls. In describing the port, Forbes commented, "From pretty awful graphical issues, such as tiling textures and quite a painful menu system, this port really doesn't do this classic game justice." US Gamer characterized the Windows release as carrying all the markings of a project farmed out to the lowest bidder. It's a shrug in Square Enix's mind, seemingly not worth the money or effort necessary for a half-decent port. In a Twitter post detailing his experiences with the Windows version, indie developer Fred Wood derisively compared the port to someone's first attempt at an RPG Maker game, a comment which was republished across numerous articles addressing the poor quality of the re-release. Chrono Trigger inspired several related releases, the first were 3 titles released for the Satellaview on July 31, 1995. They included Chrono Trigger, Jet Bike Special, a racing video game based on a minigame from the original, Chrono Trigger, Character Library, featuring profiles on characters and monsters from the game, and Chrono Trigger, Music Library, a collection of music from the game's soundtrack. The contents of Character Library and Music Library were later included as extras in the PlayStation re-release of Chrono Trigger. Production IG created a 16-minute OVA entitled which was shown at the Japanese V-Jump Festival of July 31, 1996. There have been 2 notable attempts by Chrono Trigger fans to unofficially remake parts of the game for PC with a 3D graphics engine. Chrono Resurrection, an attempt at remaking 10 small interactive cutscenes from Chrono Trigger, and Chrono Trigger Remake Project, which sought to remake the entire game, were forcibly terminated by Square Enix by way of a cease and desist order. Another group of fans created a sequel via a ROM hack of Chrono Trigger called, developed from 2004 to 2009, although feature-length and virtually finished, it also was terminated through a cease and desist letter days before its May 2009 release. The letter also banned the dissemination of existing Chrono Trigger ROM hacks and documentation. After the cease and desist was issued, an incomplete version of the game was leaked in May 2009, though due to the early state of the game, playability was limited. This was followed by a more complete ROM leak in January 2011, which allowed the game to be played from beginning to end. Square released a 4th Satellaview game in 1996, named. Having thought that Trigger ended with unfinished business, Scenarist Masato Kato Rodian directed the game. Dreamers functioned as a side story to Chrono Trigger, resolving a loose subplot from its predecessor. A short, text-based game relying on minimal graphics and atmospheric music, the game never received an official release outside Japan, though it was translated by fans to English in April 2003. Square planned to release Radical Dreamers as an Easter egg in the PlayStation edition of Chrono Trigger, but Kato was unhappy with his work and halted its inclusion. Square released Chrono Cross for the Sony PlayStation in 1999. Cross is a sequel to Chrono Trigger featuring a new setting and cast of characters. Presenting a theme of parallel worlds, the story followed the protagonist Serge, a teenage boy thrust into an alternate reality in which he died years earlier. With the help of a thief named Kid, Serge endeavors to discover the truth behind his apparent death and obtain the Frozen Flame, a mythical artifact. Regarded by writer and director Masato Kato as an effort to redo Radical Dreamers properly, Chrono Cross borrowed certain themes, scenarios, characters, and settings from Dreamers. Yasunori Mitsuda also adapted certain songs from Radical Dreamers while scoring Cross. Radical Dreamers was consequently removed from the series' main continuity, considered an alternate dimension. Chrono Cross shipped 1.5 million copies and was almost universally praised by critics. There are no plans for a new title, despite a statement from Hironobu Sakaguchi in 2001 that the developers of Chrono Cross wanted to make a new Chrono game. The same year, Square applied for a trademark for the names Chrono Break in the United States and Chrono Break in Japan. However, the United States trademark was dropped in 2003. Director Takashi Tokita mentioned Chrono Trigger 2 in a 2003 interview which has not been translated to English. Yuji Hirai expressed no interest in returning to the Chrono franchise in 2005, while Hironobu Sakaguchi remarked in April 2007 that his creation Blue Dragon was an extension of Chrono Trigger. During a Cube to Cube interview on February 1, 2007, Square Enix's senior vice president Hiromichi Tanaka said that although no sequel is currently planned, some sort of sequel is still possible if the Chrono Cross developers can be reunited. Yasunori Mitsuda has expressed interest in scoring a new game, but warned that there are a lot of politics involved with the series. He stressed that Masato Kato should participate in development. The February 2008 issue of Game Informer ranked the Chrono series 8th among the top 10 sequels in demand, naming the game Steadfast Legacies in the Square Enix catalog and asking, "What's the damn holdup?" In Electronic Gaming Monthly's June 2008 retro issue, writer Jeremy Parrish cited Chrono as the franchise video game fans would be most thrilled to see a sequel to. In the first May Famitsu of 2009, Chrono Trigger placed 14th out of 50 in a vote of most wanted sequels by the magazine's readers. At E3 2009, SE Senior Vice President Shinji Hashimoto remarked, "If people want a sequel, they should buy more." Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.